Hey guys, there's a new weapons of victory. I wonder what the Germans or Japanese got, or even what the U.S. or British got. Oh, this is going to be awesome. Let's see exactly what they got. Something deep down told me I should have known that it wasn't going to be anything else but Russian units to take place in this special event. Because that's all what it's about. It's all about the Reds. That's all it is. Nobody else. Who cares about anybody else? Nobody else plays the other nations. Now, nobody cares about, you know, the U.S. or Germany or the British or the Japanese. Everybody just cares about the Soviets. I really hope you can tell that there's sarcasm in what I am saying. And it's also coming with a decal. Or a decal, whoever you are. And this also makes it even more confusing as to when this event will take place, because there is now more than the week of the thing for the celebration and the crap. Whatever, you know what I'm trying to say. Okay, I'm going to have to do a little bit of explaining here. In my Yak9M video, somebody posted a comment saying that they understand where my frustration is coming from, but they also, you know, any new unit to the game is, you know, great for them. And that it is for me too. Any new unit to the game, the more units the better. I love any unit, whether it's a modification of one, an entirely new one, a unique one, a premium one, although if I do miss out on one of the exclusives, of course I'm a little bit frustrated with that. But, you know, any new unit is good. However, the Russians get pampered so much to the, you know, I mean, a lot of people don't play the Russians, okay? I know a few friends that don't touch the Russians and never will, probably. And, you know, when you do this special event on the Victory in Europe Day, and then you just give the Russians, like, six different special units, and like one for the British and the U.S. and none for the Japanese and the Germans, and before you start waffling on, oh yeah, well, the Japanese and the Germans, the Japanese weren't in the Europe, and the Germans didn't have victory, so, you know, they don't really need anything. Yeah, that's bullcrap. Okay, every nation could get something for this event. But for Soviets to get, like, every vehicle in the game, I mean, let's see. It seems like every time there's an update, right, with aviation in it, okay, each nation gets, like, three aircraft, and the Russians get six. When a new nation gets a premium unit, the Russians get two new premium units. When a nation gets an exclusive unit, the Russians get their own exclusive unit. And when there's a special event like this going on, let's see, one and two other people get something, so two other exclusives go, and then the Russians get one, two, three, four, and two of them being ground forces, and two of them being aviation. And who knows what else is going to come around. But again, you mean the IS-2, 1944, I love this. I love that vehicle, because I'm dirty, but still. The Russians are continuously getting non-stop milked, if you want to use that term, out of every different little event that comes around. A little exclusive event like this, and you get thousands of Russian units. And then, you know, like I said, and then the next update that's going to come out, the Russians are going to get, like, 20 ground vehicles over the one that some other nation gets. So, again, you know, like I tried saying earlier, I'm excited because it's a new vehicle, but at the same time, I'm disappointed because it's yet another Russian vehicle. You know, it wouldn't frustrate me so much if, you know, Gaijin would do the fair thing and, say, give each nation two units and then say, okay, then we're releasing these two Russian units because the Russians haven't gotten any units yet. Not, you know, okay, look, guys, United States get this unit. The British get, or and then the Russians get this unit, the British get this unit, the Russians get this unit, the Russians get this unit, the Russians get this unit, and you get the idea. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and join me in the next War Thunder video. Again, I mean, this does still confuse me about the whole event that's going on now, because, whatever. I'm done ranting about that, I already ranted about that in a while.